Welcome to another episode of Powered by Snowflake, where I interview technology leaders building applications and businesses on Snowflake. Today, we'll be learning how UiPath has built an automation platform on top of Snowflake. And with me is Param Kahlon, Chief Product Officer of UiPath. Param, how are you today?
Very good, Daniel. Delighted to be here. Thanks for having us on the show.
Absolutely. I'm excited to talk with you today. So an automation platform is no small feat. I mean, tell me more about what the company does, you know, your background and kind of some context around UiPath here.
Absolutely. I've been at UiPath about 4 years now. I've spent my career in enterprise software building business applications with Microsoft prior to UiPath. Spent 5-6 years at Microsoft building business applications for Dynamics 365 and then spent time before that at SAP and Siebel, which is part of Oracle now. You know, UiPath was founded in 2005 by engineers that were building software for other engineers to consume. And we kind of stumbled into the automation market. Back then it was called RPA, somewhere in 2013, 2014 timeframe, where some of the technology that would create it, help people create automation to automate the mundane, the repetitive tasks that were generally in the back office. And from there on, you know, given the shift in demographics around the world, given the need for people to do more with less, there has been a tremendous demand for the automation platform that has accelerated our growth through the last 4 or 5 years. In fact, analysts have called the automation category is the fastest growth enterprise business application category for the last 2 years in a row. We were very fortunate to get some really accredited private investors as it was going through the growth curve. We raised more than $1 billion for the company through private investors. And last year, we went IPO in the public market in New York Stock Exchange. So we're now listed as a public company under the symbol PATH.
That's incredible. So tell me about some of the examples of customers that you work with and kind of the solution that you built.
Absolutely. So what companies are trying to do with our software is able to leverage existing assets that they have in existing technologies and be able to automate processes, leveraging those, transform their processes digitally without having to re-engineer systems from the ground up. So we've got customers like SMBC Bank in Japan, for example, that have automated more than 1,000 processes, and they measure the value that our software delivers to their business. They've now measured more than $500 million of savings that we've generated to their organization by saving hundreds and thousands of hours. In fact, write about us in our annual report. So a lot of the automations that we create help people to create automation so that they can go focus on the work at hand on creating value. So for example, somebody working in a contact center can focus on communicating with the customer as opposed to trying to click and navigate through different systems to get work done. So we've got customers like Pepsi that have used us in back office financial processes, customers like HP that use us across front office and back office processes. Our software is a generic automation platform that isn't specific to an industry or a process. It can be applied to create automations, whether they're in the back office, doing stuff without any human intervention, or they could be in the front office, like in a contact center, where the agent, the user can focus on doing the work that humans are best at, just the creative, empathetic aspects of our nature, and not have to focus on clicking different things on the screen and navigating across different applications.
To have built a platform that is so cross-industry and use case agnostic, it has to be pretty agile in terms of how you built it. Tell me why and how you decided to build this on top of Snowflake.
Absolutely. So first of all, the platform that we built can assume that we can work with any interface that is available on the computer screen. So we're able to tap and work with any application, whether it's displayed in a browser or in a Windows application on a virtual desktop interface. Our robots help execute business processes across these interfaces or APIs that exist across these applications. Now, as the robots go complete these business processes, they log everything they're creating because that is an audit requirement for companies to be able to manage and control and report on how businesses are completing different transactions. And now, as those robots create those logs, we needed a system that's able to not only understand what the robots are doing and be able to report on it, but also provide both operational and business metrics at a scale that was really large, because not only were our customers large and doing a lot of transactions through our system, but as those robots were processing those transactions, we wanted a system that was able to scale to the needs of our customers. And that's why we decided the right platform for us is a platform that can scale and grow as our needs and our customers' needs are growing. And that's why we build that ability to ingest all those robot logs and report and measure the impact of those automations using Snowflake.
So that's really cool to see. I totally agree with you. Scale is critical to an operation like this. Can you show me a high level overview of kind of how the data flows through UiPath and you know, through Snowflake in this case? Can you show me a little bit about that?
Absolutely. I'd love to give you a quick demonstration of sort of how that works. I'm going to share my screen. So first of all, just very quickly, sort of the architecture of what we've created using Snowflake. So as these robots are completing business processes, they are ingesting a lot of information about the business process, whether they were successful or not, how often they were used, how many times does the robot run, how long did it take for it to execute the process, how much time do we save in executing that? And all of those metrics and the logs are really important. So scale was important, but I was also really important the ability to process unstructured information, just like we process structured information. So for example, if a robot is executing a process in the back office, it's capturing some information about that invoice or the accounts payable processes. And the same robot can now go ahead and turn around and process some information from an employee onboarding process or a customer service request management process. So the structure, the unstructured or the semi-structured nature of information that the robots are capturing across different process executions was also important for us to make sure that we're able to understand. So what we created in Snowflake is not only scale, but be also be able to process custom fields and unstructured information and be able to analyze and report on them. So we take all of the data from the robot logs that we are processing and ingest it into our data lake, which is able to report on both the outcomes that are focused on operational metrics, like how many robots have got, how many processes they have executed, what's the success rate, but also in the ROI, the business ROI metrics, as in how efficient are we after putting this process in place? Have we reduced the cycle time for a certain process? How many hours have you saved? How does that account into the metrics in terms of the dollar savings that account us to? So if you go look at the demo of the product that I'd love to show you as well, here I've logged into our cloud platform. That's where our automation services are. And what we do is in this cloud platform, we can, you know, using Studio, help build automations quickly. We have Orchestrator that helps manage the deployment of those automations that we build. We've got actions where we can engage humans in and robots together to help orchestrate the end-to-end process. So on the left-hand side, we essentially offer all the services that are available to our customers from an end-to-end automation platform.
That's awesome. You know, I see insights there. You know, I assume, yeah, that's probably a key area that Snowflake plays a role.
That's absolutely correct. And Insights is where Snowflake is powered by Snowflake. So if you click on Insights here, what we can do with Insights is help manage and measure the impact that automations are having on the business. So what we provide is out of the box, we provide certain templates or dashboards that our customers can use to start to measure different metrics that they care about, right? And they can configure and customize these metrics. So for example, if we jump into some of the operational metrics like processes, queues, and robots. And I'll jump into processes here to kind of see what that metrics around processes may look like. But in processes metrics, you know, we care about different metrics from processes. For example, how many processes we have run on average, how long does a process take, what's the success rate, are we, you know, successful or not? And then, you know, other key metrics that might be important for us. So one of the things that I care a lot about is, you know, what's happening with the processes that have failed jobs. There are certain processes that's failing more often than others. And what does that mean? So I can click on this and quickly drill in on that process and get a list of, you know, what are the types of errors people are seeing with this process that is failing a lot. So I can kind of hone in and get to the details of that. What's also nice about these dashboards and charts is that as I can drill in, but I can also take this data and I can export this data into whatever format that I'm more comfortable consuming and using. For example, I'm going to take these error messages and send them to my IT analyst to go look at and find out why we're having these failed executions. I can look at the data and I can export it directly from here and be able to do that. Another thing that our customers can do with this is they can set up alerts. So for example, if they come in here and I want to get alerted anytime my success rate falls below a certain threshold, I can click on this alert icon here and I can say whenever the success rate is less than, let's say 80, I want to get an email and I want to get that email every day at 5 a.m. till the time that is happening. So I can set up those alerts very easily and get notified on things without having to come to this dashboard and monitor this metric on a daily basis.
That's really powerful to see. One of the things that always comes to mind when I see dashboards like this is how you're ingesting a lot of data, right? That data is going into Snowflake. How are you deciding, you know, when to trigger and make new calculations in this dashboard?
That's absolutely correct. So what we do is all of this data is streamed near real time to this dashboard. So one of the things, for example, we do is I'll go back into my insights dashboard and we've got business metrics in here as well. So for example, we look at the business ROI dashboard and over here, the metrics that we care about are relevant from a business perspective. We look at things, for example, the hours saved or the dollars saved. And for example, if I change this metric and say, I want to look at, let's say, the last 365 days, how much time have you saved through automations and how much money has it saved? You can kind of get those metrics. Now, you may ask, like, how do we actually set this up? How do we know we've saved that much money? It's all configurable. So we can click on this here and configure the ROI data set. Over here, we decide sort of for every process, right? What did it take for us to manually complete that process, right? In minutes or hours or however metric we set up, what was the hourly cost of the person that was actually executing that metric? What was the development cost for that? What was the number of FTEs that were reduced and that was a license cost of that? So very quickly, we can come in here and configure these dashboards, however we want to do it. And if I wanted to add, let's say another cost metric that influenced the overall cost of this, I can quickly come in here and I can say, whether this is, for example, digital transformation relevant or not, because we may have a special cost associated to things that we're doing for digital transformation. And as easy as that, we've not created another metric that I can use in my calculations to power the metrics that my dashboards are using to these. So super flexible and super easy to use these things.
That's awesome. You know, and I see here also that when you were just at the dashboard selections page, right? Those are different templates. I assume with these templates, are you able to edit, modify kind of to your liking? You know, if you have a specific use case or something like that, can you edit these dashboards?
Yeah, absolutely. It's a great question. So for example, just with one click, I can take this dashboard, I can copy it, right? And this would create a copy of the dashboard that we've got. Now, I've copied this dashboard, I've copied it because I want to personalize it to my taste and my liking. Right. So as soon as I come in here, now it's completely editable. Right. If I can come in here and click a button and say, edit this dashboard, I come in here and I can say, here's my dashboard. I want to, for example, take this, you know, chart over here and move it to the top. Maybe I don't like the way the chart is arranged. I can click on edit mode and launch into the design of this dashboard. I can change the visualization of this dashboard. I can also change what fields are available, what things that I want to look at. So it's completely configurable. For example, if I just want to change this from horizontal column-based chart to bar-based chart, I can do this and I can save it. And just like that, I've now saved my chart to look like this and very easy to move these metrics around and do whatever I want to do with them. Again, super easy, super configurable for me to do. And this is what our customers love about our platform. It is that it is not just a way to create automation and not knowing what impact these are having on their business. You know, with Snowflake, we've created the ability for our customers to say, without having to invest in any analytical tool that they have to do themselves, it is ingesting that information, that data, to give them the metrics, to give them the dashboards out of the box so that as soon as they start building automations and deploying them, they're able to measure the impact that these are having on their business.
That's awesome. One of the things that always comes up with these types of applications is, especially when you're building on Snowflake, is that scaling factor that you mentioned earlier. And one of the key aspects that Snowflake provides out of the box is the ability to ingest all marketplace data, right? So to give even more kinds of relevant insights that, you know, for example, if you wanted to ingest weather data, you can get that actually for free on the marketplace. Are there ways that or elements in the future for UiPath that you see leveraging Snowflake data marketplace?
Yeah, no, that's definitely extremely one of the primary reasons we chose an open platform like Snowflake. As we look at the robots execute business processes and they have a lot of information that's relevant to what they're executing. But the information is even more powerful when we're able to combine it with other things that are happening in the ecosystem. So robots are executing automated processes, but there are a lot of processes that are happening that are automated by humans as well. Other metrics and information that is available within the ecosystem or outside the ecosystem about the process, let's say an ERP report makes certain information relevant and useful for that. We can look at all of that information and we can ingest all of that and combine the power of robot logs with the information that's available through the marketplace connectors to really give more power and more value to our customers.
That's awesome. And so kind of from here, what's next for UiPath, you know, 6 months, 1 year down the road?
You know, we see the value of the platform evolving. So when we started, we were focused on creating automations that were focused on UI automations, and that's what a lot of our customers do today. But our platform is evolving now. One of the things that we've created is process mining, where we can observe system logs of what human activities, right, that they're using in, either in creating event logs or human activities in a desktop, and created process mining and task mining products that's mining how work's getting done in the enterprise. We're bringing those logs. We're bringing logs from products like Automation Hub, which is an idea management platform where it says how we're, you know, generating ideas for automation. So we're basically creating Snowflake as a central repository of all the things that are happening around automation, whether they're for extracting information from documents, whether they're for building low-code application experiences that our platform is evolving to, or whether they're for building task mining and process mining. So we're bringing all of this data together. And with this, we're also adding a lot of machine learning capabilities on top of this data. So our intent at the end of the day is for customers to come to this place to truly understand what business processes do they have in the enterprise. How are they executing these business processes today? How have they evolved over time? And how do they compare to the benchmarks and the industry? So they can look at an order to cash process and they can say, our order to cash lead times is, you know, so many days. How can we reduce that lead time to be the best in the industry? How far are we away from the benchmarks and how much, you know, have we progressed towards that over the last 12 months, over the last 18 months? All of that is going to be powered through the Snowflake and UiPath Insights.
That's going to be awesome. You know, and I love that you're able to get such business relevant insights using a platform like that. So for our viewers here, right, where should they go if they want to learn more about you and UiPath?
Absolutely. So I would highly recommend you come to our website, uipath.com/insights. You would get all the information about our products. We have a very open ecosystem around the community. We have more than 1 million members engaged in our community. You can sign up for an instance of UiPath directly there and start to use it and play it. We definitely welcome all the feedback and any ideas you have for us improving our products.
And for everybody watching here today, if you're interested in building your next application or business on Snowflake, check out developers.snowflake.com. Thanks.
Thank you very much, Daniel. Bye.